channel. Thank you for coming back. Thank you for your support. I appreciate much. But if you're new here, you are welcome, and please don't leave this channel without subscribing. Remember to hit the notification bell so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video. You will not regret at all. So do it now. So guys, today's video is going to be a very interesting video because I am sharing with you the challenges of a black woman in Italy. I've been in Italy for 3 years now, almost four. I've faced a lot of challenges in all these years. I also have friends who live in Italy, black women. We always share, talk the challenges. So that is what we're going to be discussing today. And it is going to be a little bit of a story time vlog. I'll also be inserting some clips. So let us start our video now. Challenge number one of an African woman in Italy is hair. As you all know guys, some of us African women, we like wearing wigs, we like putting on extensions, we like relaxing our hair. Like me, I cannot stand combing my hair, so I prefer relaxing it. Because it's softened, you know, us black women, we have a very hard hair to comb. So the simple way is to relax the hair. But if you are here in Italy and you are new, you don't know where to buy the relaxing cream, you don't know where to buy the extensions, you don't know where to buy wigs, it is going to be a very big challenge. I remember when I came here to live, I stayed like 3 months and then my hair had grown. I wanted to relax it. So I told my husband, I need to relax my hair. We need to buy a relaxing cream. So we went to a cosmetic shop and we checked everywhere, guys. We checked and checked and checked, but we did not find a relaxing cream. Everything that I saw was strange and new. The products which were there. After some time, I came to know that here in my city, there are some those Asian African shops where you can buy the relaxing creams for African hair. But at first, if you're new, you don't know anywhere, it's a challenge. Another challenge about hair is if you want to go to a salon. It is really expensive. I remember I went to an African salon here in my city and it was really expensive. Making hair is expensive. If you want to do braids, oh my God, it is expensive. And if you want to buy extensions, it is super, super expensive because here there are no shops where they sell extensions, where they sell wigs. They are not there at all. I've checked and checked and checked. They are not there. You only need to buy online. I remember also, I bought this extension. Do you see this extension, guys? This one. This is two-piece extension. I bought it at 200 euro in the salon, this African salon here in our city. You can see how expensive it is, this hair. If I go online and check for this hair, I think I'll get it for maybe 100 euro, but I bought it at 200 euros. So you can see how big of a challenge it is. Compared to the country where I come from, this hair, okay, this one, this one is gonna be expensive, yes. But the synthetic one, you can buy a synthetic hair in my country at 5 euro, 10 euros, and it is easy to find. You'll also look beautiful. But here, even the synthetic hair, they are super expensive, guys. That's the reality. So we prefer buying online. We buy hair online, and also most of African women have learned how to do their own hair, how to take care of their hair. I also used to go to the salon to trim my eyebrows, but right now, oh my God, I'm a profession. I can trim my eyebrows very well due to the situation, so you need to adjust. Challenge number two is beauty products. It is really difficult to find beauty products that suits our skin as black women here in Italy. Most of the products in the drugstores especially, they are for white women. And it's because they are many, we are few. It is hard to find beauty products that suits us. I remember going to the drugstore to look for Vaseline, the petroleum one. I asked and they were so surprised, they did not know what it was. I even went to the pharmacy to look for Vaseline. I did not find it. The Vaseline they showed me wasn't that one. But in the end, I found it at the Asian African store where they sell African products. So if you are new, you don't know anywhere, it is going to be a challenge to find the products that you are used to. Challenge number three of a black woman here in Italy is finding friends. If you're coming from a country which speaks English only, it is going to be a very big challenge. You're going to get lonely. You know why? Because Italian speaks Italian. And most Africans who live here in Italy, especially where I live, it is in North Italy, Piemonte, a lot of Africans who are here, they are Ivorians, and Ivorians speaks French. So you cannot communicate, language barrier. You end up lonely. Yes, they are black just like you. You really feel like you should talk to them. Maybe they'll understand you more. You are in a new country. You don't know anyone. So if you see a black person, you're like, oh my God. Oh, thank God I can talk to this person. But they don't speak English. They speak French. And very few Nigerians, because Nigerians speaks English, especially this side, we are near to France. So it is French that is used, French and Italian. So if you live in a place like this, it is going to be a very big challenge to find friends. I want to show you a little bit of a vlog of what I do in just a normal day. Hi guys. So today is those normal days. It's in the morning around 11. We came out with Sophie to take a walk, take sun, because today we have a little bit of a sun. So we come here to take sun, run here and there, because if you have a little baby in the house, sometimes if you stay indoors for so long, she gets tired and starts to cry for no reason. So I prefer to go out, take a walk and have fun. So that is what we are doing. Back to what I want you to understand is that life here in Italy is a bit different. If you are an English speaking person, it's very hard to get friends. Like now, if I was in my country, which is Tanzania, I could have just gone to visit friends or my relatives or just go some places, but I cannot do that here because I have few friends and the family of my husband, whereby you can't just go and visit people every day. That's not possible. And if we go visiting, then we just stay for just a while, 30 minutes maximum. But sometimes we just go visit for 10 minutes. For me, it is really strange, because for us, like Africans, when we go visiting, we can even visit the whole day. We stay there the whole day, then in the evening we go back home if it is in the weekend. But very different, and it's a challenge, guys. It's a very big challenge to get friends. So this is our life. That is Sophie in the background. And the other reason that I bring her here is because now we are in lockdown here in Italy. We can't even go to the parks. I don't want to risk. So I prefer here because it's an open place and there is fresh air. I have experienced it. So, as black women, when you get pregnant, you're about to be a new mom. You get advice from your friends, from your sister, from your mother, those who have experience. They help you out through the way of your pregnancy. But when you're here in Italy, again, they speak Italian. You don't understand the language. And those friends are not there, your sisters are not there, your mother is not there to give you advice, to tell you, don't worry about this, it is okay, it is normal. If you see this, don't worry, it is a challenge, a very big challenge. I remember back in the days, I had this friend, she was pregnant, and we used to take her for a walk every evening because her pregnancy was almost approaching the end for delivery. So we used to walk with her in the evening so that she can do the exercise. So I could go as a best friend sometimes, and the other times her sister could go, her mother could go. So it was a very good thing, and it entered my mind like, when I get pregnant, it is going to be like that. I'll have my sisters, I'll have my friends who will help me out. But when you are here in Italy, it is different, guys. Those friends are not there. You are alone. Sometimes you see things and you wonder, what is this? What can I do about this? What will help you out is Google. You'll have to Google everything about motherhood so that you can understand how to go about it. Another thing I remember, when I became a new mom, my baby had colic, guys. A very strong colic. I got confused. I did not know what to do. Whenever I could call my sister, she could tell me, oh, if you are here, we could give that baby herbs, you know, African herbs, and she could be fine. But unfortunately, I was in Italy. That thing disturbed my mind a lot, because here, if a baby isn't 3 weeks, you cannot give that baby anything. So I wish to grow wings and be in Africa with my baby. It is a very big challenge if you are a first mom. Another incident I remember, I woke up one morning when my baby was starting to grow teeth. I saw something long like this in her gums. I got confused. I called my husband. My husband came and he did not know what it was. We called the baby doctor, and the baby doctor said, wait until tomorrow so that you can come. I started crying. I called my sister again and I told her. She was like, no, it's okay, it's nothing, it's the tooth that wants to grow, don't worry about it. But I kept on worried. The next morning, it was tooth, guys. I'm going to wonder, I haven't talked about racism till now. Isn't racism a challenge in Italy? Guys, racism for me, I think, is a person's behavior, because some Italians will treat me like a queen, and some will even ask me if I have even ever gone to school. So it's a person's behavior. Even a black person can be a racist. That is why in Africa you will find tribalism. It's just the same. Challenge number five of a black woman here in Italy is, there is no house. Hell. And why it is a challenge, it is the way we grew up. I grew up knowing that if you have a baby, you can take a house help, and that house help is going to help you around the house, is going to help you with a baby if you are working. But here in Italy, it is different, because you're going to be a mom, you're going to be a wife, you will go to work, you'll take care of the house. One day I was talking to my friend, she was telling me, I'm a wife, I'm a house help, I work, I'm a gardener, I'm a constructor, I am everything, you know. But it is a challenge, guys. We are used to have house helps back at home. Used to have house help back at home in Africa because it's cheap to pay them. Here in Italy, it is really expensive to pay house help. And a normal family, just like mine, because my family is a normal one, we are not rich, so we cannot afford to pay for a house help. That goes to many families here in Italy. They don't have house helps. You be a mom, you be a house help, you be a wife, you will go to work and take care of everything. That is how it is, guys. Behind the slaying photos on Instagram, we are moms, we are gardeners, we are wives, we go to work, we do everything by ourselves. But it is a challenge because back in the mind, we know that, oh my God, if I was home, if I was in Africa, I could have a house help. That doesn't mean that all families here cannot afford to pay for a house help. No, some families can. Some families bring au pairs. Some families have people to help them around the house. But most families, guys, most families here in Italy, there is no house help. And for an African woman, it is a challenge. But we get used to it, you see. Challenge number 6 of a black woman here in Italy. If you're a black woman and you want to date an Italian man, it is going to be a big challenge because they have this mentality that all black women here are taken. They get scared to approach black women. Also, if they see you in streets, I don't know why, this is weird, they will think you are a prostitute. So they will never approach you unless you study together or work together or know you through a friend. In conclusion, guys, there is no place you're going to live in this world without challenges. Challenges are everywhere. You cannot escape that. So it's better to concentrate on the good side, on the positive side. Know why you are living the life you live, how you can change it. And if you're in Italy for love, 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 and don't get tired of it. If you're in Italy for studies, then study. It will reach an end. You'll finish your studies. In Italy for work, then work and get paid. Be happy, enjoy life.